There's a difference in this video from all the other videos that I've done, and that is that I did not ever meet the male lead of this video. I never met Gunters. I saw his picture and picked him, and then never ever met him. So if he sees this, I hope he knows that I think he did a great job. This is the first music video that Gunters had ever done, and so I'm wondering if he's ever going to want to do another music video, considering the fact that his part in this video was basically walking through snow nonstop for miles and miles and miles. He just had to keep on walking through snow, looking miserable, and walking and walking and snow, and it was a really probably freezing cold experience for him, so I'm hoping that didn't ruin his idea of music videos forever. There was an entire day of shooting for this music video that I didn't even see. I wasn't even there for. We were dealing with such a busy schedule that it worked out great that way. And I shot all of my scenes and he shot all of his scenes, and there are these two separate storylines going on, and yeah, they were shot separately. So when it came time to see the video cut for the first time, there was so much that I had no idea what this was going to look like. I thought that the parts shot in Binghamton, New York were gorgeous. I mean, exactly what I had hoped they would be. Just giant sweeping shots of snow-covered, depressing, kind of like gray clouds. Most of my videos so far have been really colorful and just really, really poppy colors. And this video was just sad and very much like the song, but my favorite part about this video is that it lets the song be the narrative. It doesn't so directly depict the story. It lets you listen to the lyric and use your imagination and put together what the story is. And it really, I think, reflects in its color tones and in the overall visual tone of the video, it reflects pining away and misery, and your whole world looks gray. And that's what the whole video looks like. It's just gray. One of my favorite scenes was the bathtub, and that's just a really subtle scene that you see just a few times during the video, but there's something so sad about someone sitting in a bathtub with their clothes on and it's snowing inside. I mean, that's sad. I really loved expressing that emotion that way, and just the way that it was shot, I will continue to be blown away by this video and just the way that it was put together and shot.
This is so emotional.
This is the first time I've worked with Johan, my director for this video, and I just loved how when we were putting out this single, he submitted a treatment without us contacting him or without even us going out and saying, hey directors, does anybody want to write a treatment? He was like one of the first people to jump the gun and be like, I have an idea for this, I want to do this, this song means this and this and this to me, and I have picture references and this is what I want to do. And just the go-getter-ness of that was really cool, and you know, it's just really inspiring to be around people who really love what they do and go after it. And it was really taking a step outside my comfort zone of working with directors I'd worked with before. And taking that chance, I'm so glad I did, because this video looks nothing like anything else I've ever done. Another difference from this video and all my other videos is that there was no clothing change. There was one outfit for the entire video. And that outfit was really low key. And it was like an outfit you would wear pining away sitting in your house alone. I didn't wear that much makeup. My hair was a little different, a little more disheveled. And I really love that it came out that way. There was a part of the video that Johan had seen in his head from the very first conception that he had of the video. Just the idea that there would be like a breath of air on my neck and you would see my hair move, and it was kind of symbolic that when the guy breathed, I could kind of feel it. That these two people are bonded even though they're not together anymore and everything's all messed up. And I thought that was really beautiful, and it carried through just the same way in the video. there was a letter in the video. I talked to Yoan about it. I said I thought there should be something, some sort of like, in the end, he finally knows that I miss him. And instead of doing that really obviously, of like actually standing in front of him saying I'm sorry for that night, I wanted it to be a little more subtle than that. And I wanted it to be a letter that I'm writing this entire time, and I'm pining away for him and thinking about what I want to say and writing it on this letter. And, you know, a lot of people have asked me, what does the letter say in the end? Because he reads it and he's like, oh my God. I imagine that the letter basically is the lyrics to Back to December. Like, I'm sorry, I messed this whole thing up. I want you back. How'd you feel about that?
C'est une fin de tournage!
Now that I've seen the video, it just is one of my favorite ones we've done, to be honest. It's so, like, it's just so exactly what the song needed and different than anything we'd ever done before. I love that. I love taking chances and having it pay off, because sometimes you take chances and you fall flat on your face. But this time around, it really worked out.